everyone, HBI Guys Model Workshop here, and as you'll notice, we are not on my usual workbench to show you a kit, and that's because this kit will not fit on my usual workbench. This kit will have to be built and assembled on a very large table that I have in my workshop for building kits of this size, for building model airplanes and such. This is a radio-controlled, steam-operated paddle wheeler, and the kit is designed by Dumas, or Dumas, D-U-M-A-S. It's called the Myrtle Cory, and it's a type of tow boat and push boat that would have been used in the southern states back in the days of steam. And you can see that it's going to build into an absolute beautiful ship. And you can see the dimensions right there. 38 inches long and 8¼ inches wide. Now, this kit normally retails right now in the sub $300 range just for the kit, and that's not everything you need. Of course, you're going to need paints and nails and glues, and but that's, you're also going to need operating equipment, and operating equipment is going to consist of at least a two-channel radio control transmitter, a receiver, at least one servo to operate the rudder, and a motor package and a battery package for the boat, and we'll talk about that in just a little bit. As you can see out in front of you right now is the giant plans, and as you can see over here, it says, note, the drawings have been reduced to 75% of original size. That means these giant plans, these beautiful plans, aren't even the full size of the boat when we get done with it. But you can see that the absolute wonderful detail on there, it's in 1/20th scale, which would make it, you know, absolutely gigantic. But you can see that it's going to be a very cool looking ship, and you will hang these on the wall, these plans, so that you can get a good idea of exactly how you're putting things together and what you're working on when you're working on it. Now for the big reveal here, I'm going to take the plans away and show you everything that comes in just the box, just what you get for the kit, and that doesn't include everything you need. So we'll get these monster sized plans out of the way, and there it is. There are all the parts that you will need to begin your assembly of this boat. And we're going to go to the left, and we're going to go to the right, and you're going to look at all that stuff, all that wood, all those plastic parts. Now, one of the nice things about this being a paddle boat, being a paddle wheeler, is that the hull, they do not make you build the entire hull. A lot of these wood kit ships, you do have to lay out plastic, you have to lay out formers, wood formers, in the shape of a hull, and then you have to plank the hull. And you end up planking the hull, you know, with thin wood strips like this. You end up having to take a strip like this and run it down the hull and tack it and glue it to every single hull former and heat it up and bend it to the correct shape. What they do with this one, because it is a flat bottom boat, it would be very, very difficult to make a leak-proof flat bottom boat as a model. So they do give you an injection molded hull, and we'll take a look at that. That's the monster right there. And you can see that's a very thick piece of blow molded plastic that they have on there. And that's the back, the way it rounds off. And then, of course, it's a flat bottom because it is a riverboat. And they have to let the current go underneath it, and it needs a shallow draft so that it doesn't get caught up on any stumps and logs, because rivers are full of crap like that. And then it does have a V-hull for cutting the current a little bit as it goes around it and to help it with stability going straight up the river. And you'll take out a saw and you'll cut along this line and cut that entire hull out, all the way around. Very similar to what you do with an RC car body. This is just much more rigid, solid plastic, and you can see the size of that is just about 3 feet long right there. There's some other blow molded plastic parts in the kit that I can let you take a look at. And this right here doesn't seem like much, this flexible plastic here. What this is you will end up cutting along the edge here all the way around, and this will build one of the decks, one of the largest, the first deck on the boat. This will be the upper deck that you can start gluing your planking to and your roof panels to, and then you'll build another deck on top of that and another one, and then you'll put another roof all the way up. You know, you'll build one deck here on the hull, then another one for all the different cabins and storage areas and where the steam engine goes. So you're dealing with some substantially sized parts here, and you're dealing with a lot of them. You can see the smaller cabin roof deck right there. Everything has a little bit of curve to it because that's how the boat was designed. You can see that's, I mean, we're still looking at some monster-sized parts, and you'll just end up cutting that out. They've got some locators here for the supports, the actual wood supports that will come up and support each roof as you go through. And I'll have to give you guys another shot of the boat so that you can understand what I'm talking about. We're talking about these decks right here, the main deck that's all wood planked, and then each deck that goes above it. And you can see that you've got your wheelhouse here, your captain's house, you've got the quarters here, you've got your roof with your open deck on the back, and then you've got your main roof where the smokestacks come through and are all rigged up. And then you've got your pushers in the front. So you can kind of see where we're going with that, those plastic parts and that plastic hull. There are some other blow molded and standard foamy styrene style parts. These are for your smokestacks. These are going to be for part of your engine. That's your steam engine. That's, you're going to end up cutting these out and building them per the instructions to build what's going to look like a steam engine inside the hull. And this is all electrical. It doesn't actually run on steam, though you could convert it to run on steam. But this one isn't going to be doing that. And what's kind of neat is because of the scale of this ship, this right here, this standard piece of PVC, this half-inch PVC, that's going to be part of your smokestacks. So that's pretty cool that they got that there. Just looks like PVC, but when you're all done, this ship is so big that it's going to be part of the smokestack system with the decoration on top. Now you're going to, we've got two manuals here to help build this ship. We've got this manual here, which is all your drawings and your figures to actually show you how to assemble. And then you've got this book, this small novella here, and that will actually, you'll go through this at the same time and you'll read through and you'll start out building the stand, figure one. And then you're just going to go right to these plans and you're going to look for figure one and you're going to start assembling it. Now, like I said, to give you an idea of how in-depth this is, the manual here gives you the parts call out, and then, you know, you're 40, 50 pages into it as you start going through all the destructions, as I call them. These are the figure drawings. These are going to be the ones that most people use the most of, and they're going to, you know, it's much easier to build when you're looking at that, but you can see all the planking and building involved in a kit like this. These are definitely craftsman's kits. You are going to build your window frames, your door frames, out of the wood included, and start putting everything together in the correct way so that you end up with an absolute gorgeous, fully operational paddle wheeler that you can take out to a boat landing and you can put it in the water and you can drive it around. You can see they're having you build the ship's wheel right there, because everything is built down to the tiniest parts, because in 1/20th scale on a ship this size, you end up with massive things, so you can super detail it. You can see in here how to hook up the motor to the metal base with the brass rod that they'll include and the plastic gears, and how to set all that up so that it rotates these arms back and forth, and actually, you know, the rocker arm will make the paddle wheel go up and down and start working like that. So let's move beyond the directions and start looking at some of the parts in the kit. Of course, this is easy to know what this is. This is just acetate Lexan plastic. This is for your windows. You'll just peel the protective film off each side and start making your windows out of that. What's left on the table here in front of us are the massive die-punched plastic parts. You can see the size of the cabin's going to have. You know, that's a door, and that's the wall to the cabin. And some other deck parts like the roof and the outer decks to the captain's area. So you can see how nice and big this monster is going to be. And no space was wasted. Here's one of your deck formers right there. That'll go on top of the main deck where you can actually start planking. And it's a styrene plastic, but it's a very thick plastic, and it's almost got like an air-blown feel to it. You can see that it's quite flexible, so it'll give quite a bit, but it glues and works just like styrene. This single piece right here is your actual stand that you'll build benches for and set your model on. You get an idea of how, you know, again, how absolutely massive this kit's going to be. Here's a little bit of thinner styrene plastic. So you get to learn how to work with everything. And if you saw one of my other videos with the Model Shipways Cannon, then you're going to have an idea of how to, you know, use the different tools that I showed you in that video. You can go back and take a look at that Shipways video and see the different tools that I'll use to cut out the plastic. Now you can see what's nice about this is they give you the plastic wall and you'll assemble that on the deck and you'll punch the windows out. And then you'll be able to plank over the top of this and glue your planks or tack them depending on how you prefer to do it. What I would usually do is plank it and then cut the nail heads off and actually glue them on, because I don't want to keep driving nails through this in the plastic. I don't want to drill 6,000 holes when it's easier to just cut the nail heads off in bulk and glue them on there. So you can see more cabin walls, couple duplicate parts because you're building the ship, you know, two sides of it, of course. All nice quality plastic. They don't really skimp on the quality of the materials. Here's some very, very thin sheets for more of the cabin fronts and the doors. You can see the door cut out of that one. And, you know, give you an idea, that's my hand. So you can find some very neat figures. It is in 1/20th scale, which means that model railroad figures will work just fine. You can find a lot of accessories in a scale called G scale. G for garden and a garden railroad. Let's take a look at some of the wood they provide. Just a big stack of sticks. And these you're going to use for planking the hull, the decks, and different types of textures at different times. Planking the side of the boat, the floors of the boat. You can see all different types and styles and species of wood that they use. And it's just stacks and stacks and stacks. And you've got some that are super, super small like this. You know, you're looking at small pieces of basswood and pine. And then you've got your normal quarter inch sticks. And there's hundreds of them in here. And you're gonna, each one has its own specialty and the instruction manual will call it out as you need it. Then there's some long styrene strips that you'll be using to bolt on the rudders and make angles across the bottom of the hull so that they actually do direct the water in the correct way back to the paddles. There's some large wood dowels. You'll be using this to actually mount your paddle wheels to, and the paddle wheel star pattern so that you can turn that with your mechanics. And then there are very large sections of brass rod, brass wire. These will be cut and bent and used to control the rudders. This will be used to control these two thick pieces. Will be used, you'll actually have to cut it, clamp on some ring clamps on there, and attach it to the rocker arms, and that this will be used as the mechanism that goes like this over and under from the motor to drive your paddle wheel. You can see that, you know, they put everything you need in there, and then it's up to you using the plans and the directions to make it look good and to make it look realistic. Some of the more beautiful wood and a huge stack, because you're going to be using a lot of it, is this mahogany. And this is mahogany strip wood, and it's absolutely gorgeous. Now, a lot of people will whitewash this boat, and let me show you another picture so that you can see. A lot of people will do all that planking on the side and the decks in that mahogany, and then they'll whitewash it because that's kind of how it would have looked. Now, I would think that anybody who owned this boat back then would have wanted to leave it more natural like it is down here. So you could give it, I would give it a much lighter paint job, or just a, maybe like a white stain instead of a paint that's washed out, so that you can actually see much more of the wood, and that so that it actually looks well for you. The deck is going to be planked in this kind of wood here, and then you can stain that or you can paint it. You can put a darker stain on it, and you could see inside there where you're going to make your boiler, and you, this ship is just ripe for being lit. You know, you can put lights on it as if they were hanging lanterns. They do make little lantern kits and all that. You couldn't put electric lights in it, but you could put gas lights in it. And you could see the captain's wheelhouse right there, where I was showing you how you build the wheel. They do have some laser cut parts that they cut out with a laser, and those are here. That's going to be your wheel. That's just balsa wood because it serves no structural purpose, so it doesn't need to be heavy. Plus, this is sitting on the third deck of the boat, and if it was on made out of a heavier wood, you know, more and more heavier wood that you stack up towards the top of the boat is going to make it tip that much easier in a wind. These are the plywood. Now, these are very thin plywood, and they include three sheets, but the plywood will hold up more than just stamped basswood or balsa wood will. These are what you're going to make your paddle wheels from. And you're going to double up all of these, and then you're going to add your wood paddles. And they're going to have you use more wood like this for your paddles to go across there. You can see just how wide that is on there. And you'll have to cut each one out, glue it together. Got some more accessories here. These are more detailed parts like your windows, your small formers, your doors, your braces. Small details. These are all laser cut out of a much thinner basswood. You can see the corner detail on there. It's very nice. Very nicely looked. You can see that in there. We're running out of parts here, so it's not going to take much longer. We've got some decals so that you can put the name of the ship on there if you didn't want to paint it. And those look great. Those look old-fashioned, so those are going to work just fine. We've got a sheet of adhesive foil. That'll be used for different parts of the boiler area. We've got a preformed aluminum plate. This is where your actual electric motor is going to mount. And this will be bolted into the bottom of the hull so that it's steady. It'll be glued and bolted in. And then your motor is going to hang out here. The output's going to be here. You're going to have your support rods here. And then you're going to run your rocker arms off this, off, you know, the either side, so that you can actually run your paddle wheel system about a foot back in the boat. There are two bags of accessory parts, and these are the mechanics. These are actually all the small metal parts that you're going to use to build all your mechanical parts. And I can show you some of these easily. I put them in much nicer bags. You've got some brass sheet, which you'll have to cut and form to the correct way. For your mechanics, you've got your cleats and barrels. They've got a bunch of these in the box. These are cast metal. You can see that's going to be your tying off cleats when they're in port and for tying onto a barge. And then they've got some nice barrels. Get out the files. You're going to have to do a lot of work on those because they're not too precision. You can also buy, like I said, lots of G scale. G as in giraffe, George scale accessories. These are some of your small screws and parts, your eyelets, as you can see in there, for your tying off points for your rigging. Here's a steam whistle. And these are the rocker arms I talked about. There's quite a few in there. These will bolt to the metal rod, and they will spin off angle like that. And that's what's going to give you that back and forth motion of the rods that's going to drive the paddle wheel. And there's quite a few in there because you have to sort of build a technique to the back. Here's some more decoration accent pieces, all cast in white metal. And the last bag of mechanical parts, they even give you some string for rigging the stability for the smokestacks. They give you some very thick solid metal rod for running your mechanics and your paddle wheel motion devices and your electric motors and your rudders, all that back to the ship. And then they give you a large bag of smaller brass rod, smaller screws, and then they of course give you the plastic gears with the 32 pitch on there so that you can actually run it off the motor. Now I keep talking about the motor, and the motor is not included. They do not include the electric motor, and they are not cheap because it has to be a gear reduction motor. So you have to buy that separately. And we'll put this back here so you guys can actually see the ship that will be built from this. But the gear reduction motor, and I did pick one up back when I bought this, actually looks like this. And you can see it's a 6-volt motor. So when your speed control will reduce the 12-volt battery that I'll show you into a 6-volt system. And you just hook up your plugs right to there. You just solder them on. You bolt this in to this right here. This is going to bolt in across like that. Then you have your output shaft. And this motor with the, it's a gear reduction of 60 1/2 to 1. And that's why, this motor now, when I bought this before, These were around $40 with the gearbox, and that's what cost the most, is that gearbox on there. But these are a long life motor with extra strong magnets. They're designed to run hot. They're designed to run in closed environments. And the gearbox is all metal inside there. So it's not a bunch of plastic stuff that's going to snap once you get it all together. Now these motors run with the gearbox about $85 because they're custom made just for these boats. And Dumas is the only one you can get these through. So they can kind of command whatever price they wish on them. If you happen to find one, a used one, they almost never burn out. So grab it if you want to build a kit like this. Then the last accessory part that I'll show you is the giant 12-volt battery. 4.5 amp hour. It's your regular lead acid sealed battery. You can get these anywhere at hobby shops for starter batteries for model airplanes. You can find them anywhere, anything you'd need. And all you'll need after that then is a 2 or 4 channel radio and a servo. The servo is just an electric motor that will turn the rudders left and right at a variable rate depending on how much you turn the wheel on the radio. And the radio, you can either go with a 2-channel, which will give you just throttle control, or it will give you a throttle control and rudder control, or you can go with a multi-part radio, which would allow you to add a lot of accessories like a smoke machine. You can hook these up to a smoke machine inside the boiler. You can see that boiler's massive down there, and that's where you put your all your battery and equipment and stuff, because that'll just pop right off. And that's where you would hook up all your lights and all your electronics. And you could run those on small switches on the side that are hidden if you wanted. Or you can get a multi-channel radio, and then you can actually program it right from the radio. And as you flip switch on the radio and turn dials on the radio, you can turn on a smoker unit, which is obviously what I'm going to do, so I can run smoke out of those smokestacks. And you can have lanterns flickering inside the cabins. You could have a little bit of motion on the deck. You could have the old guy rocking back and forth on his seat with another $2 servo. Anything fun like that. These are huge, so the options are completely up to you. Hope you guys stuck with it for the entire time. I'm glad you watched my show. I hope you like this kit. You maybe think of building a larger model kit, because this is, you know, definitely scale modeling. It has a mixture of plastic modeling, wood modeling, boat modeling, RC car modeling because of the motors and the wiring, and then, you know, it's a detailer's dream. So once again, thanks for sticking with this extra super long open box kit review, and just, you know, thanks for sharing the videos like you guys like to do, and I appreciate your time.